prendere dopo. This part of the room. Do you mind staying on this part of the room? Go towards the center, towards the right, and
sit down.
Sorry?
Can I sit down?
I prefer to not for now. I'm sorry, you can leave your stuff if you want, but it would be better if you don't sit down.
Okay.
So that we stay like on this part of the room. But it would be better if we all go to this side of the room. Please do stand up so that we can all be on this side of the room. It's okay. Is it possible for you to, if you want to leave your stuff, let's go to this side of the room? This side of the room?
What?
Do you mind coming to this side of the room, like downstairs?
Oh.
You can leave your stuff over there if you want.
Yeah. Okay.
Do you mind like standing up for a bit? And closer so that we can all be closer to each other?
So welcome everyone, and welcome to this regional concert of social dissonance. We would like to ask you to stay for the whole hour if it's possible. We'll be inside the floor. If you decide to leave earlier, of course you're free, but we'll be asked to give us a short feedback explaining the reasons why we're doing it, just because we want to take into account What you were told that made you love so much?
To repeat, what made me laugh so much? You want me to tell it? Oh, okay. People standing here in the room. It's so hot, and nobody's talking. I'm sweating. It's talking. Right?
Their show.
Fine.
It's not my show.
Do you want to take over?
No.
Who wants to take over?
I don't
know.
Seems like you are still in control. I mean, we have about an hour and the door doors are closed, and we have an idea about breaking relations because there's no prescribed, but you know, prescribed things to do. But it's kind of like an idea. I don't think. Do we really have the opportunity to break through the conventions that we're trying to think about?
Can you think of some conventions that are taking place in this room?
Yeah, I mean, we're all kind of listening to each other right now and standing in a respectable distance to each other. I mean, it's all very kind of nice, and I think we're slowly entering into a mode where it's interesting to listen to each other and to have unexpected things, but I don't know how far we would go really, because I don't think any of us are interested in doing anything illegal. And, you know, we have an hour to do stuff. What are we going to do? After an hour is gone, then we'll go back to the way we were behaving before. How wild will we allow ourselves to behave?
What's your name?
Claire.
I'm Dominic.
I'm Sabina.
Hi, I'm from Germany.
Hello.
Nice to meet you.
Pleasure.
I'm sorry. Go ahead.
I thought maybe you two were instructed to laugh.
No,
you're doing a really good job.
Yes. I just suggested a laughing therapy. So
I thought
everyone else would love to, but I think they expected too much. They waited. It's going to happen. Right?
From Castle, and they are asking us to share some complaints with them. So, does anybody want to share one of the complaints that another person told them at the beginning?
Sure. I was told it's very hot and trapped in this room for an hour, and everyone's not talking to each other. Would you like me to repeat that?
Hmm?
Would you like me to repeat that? Hello?
Why don't they share some of their complaints with us? Can we
Have something to suggest, to propose?
Here?
Yeah?
No. I want to leave the space.
Ah, you want to leave? Yeah. Okay. Because you are bored?
Yeah, there's nothing.
There is nothing.
Is this a complaint? Sorry? Is this a complaint?
No. No, I just prefer to read a book than stay here.
Thanks. Okay.
Seem more equal if everybody wears shoes or if everybody takes off shoes.
Okay.
Okay. We'll take shoes. My smell.
So, shall we all?
I think it's fine.
I would not like to take my shoes.
No?
But
no.
I can put mine on.
Can we agree on something else? Maybe not shoes, but let's have a common characteristic.
Why?
Good question.
It's my suggestion. What's yours?
Yours, sorry?
Suggestion. What's yours?
Well, I'm surprised if you asked for a suggestion. I don't know what I'm suggesting something for.
Okay.
Are we a group?
I wonder if we're just coming up with things to fill up the time.
Well, of course we are. Polite. We can sit here in silence for now. That's the other option.
Polite.
Pardon?
Polite conversation.
It's being set up in a particular way.
We'll agree to do something and then have to have it for a moment. And then another suggestion.
I mean, we could all just get out of a book and read. We could all just get out of a book from our bags and read the rest of the hour.
Yeah.
Off and out of the we still be participating in the room.
Just as we might have been in the coffee shop, just sitting around at this time, we're supposed to talk to each other.
But as a social experiment, there's group dynamics, but there's also personality types become very obvious, and people can and can't cope with different levels of proximity and involvement, and that's going to happen. It's kind of a setup for this to happen.
Yeah, but that's the kind of intention.
Yeah, but it's probably not the only intention, though.
No.
But people are peeling off because of personality type.
Yeah. Peeling, well, did two people?
I thought you were going to skirt around the edges.
Of the whole thing?
Yeah. On first 5 second analysis.
Ah, interesting. No. I just will admit that I've done in castle.
Oh, you did it in castle? Oh, okay. I'm trying not to be rude.
Well, no, I'm pretty close, but.
Was it different in castle?
Yes.
Oh, very.
You did this in castle?
No.
You did this? So
yeah, well, it's different every time.
How was it there?
It was much more active.
Really?
But also,
what kind of activities?
Well, like physically.
Like talking?
And orally. It's the room has very different acoustics in castle. No one spoke until the last kind of 5 minutes.
No one spoke?
No.
It was more physical?
It was very physical, yeah. But that was because it was set up in that way that in which a few people, myself included, were asked to copy, I don't know your name, I'm sorry, this person here. It was in council. And the group that was there on that night, by and large, did start to copy the actions. It was a physical actions. And then, the beginning, it was set up in that way, and then it just kind of...
You weren't dealing with big questions or anything, you were much as just...
Oh, I don't think we're dealing with big questions, right? And I think in the end, the kind of, there was more material to kind of question things because of the actions. Like, it was quite a large group over the course of the hour, the amount of kind of copying and falling into line that occurred in that hour. It was interesting and it, like, very... here, I think people have to be vocal, whereas there was kind of this natural thing where the leader would change constantly and certain people just became obvious leaders and would change the actions of the group. And some people participated and didn't participate, but participated with that by not participating because they were kind of, because of the amount of movement that was occurring. Well,
yeah.
I don't know. It's probably happened before. There was definitely people in castle that had been to Apple, but because no one spoke, it didn't come out until the very end. That was always happening. Yeah.
So it's called social dissonance, right? And we're supposed to explore each other's differences, but, I mean, again, there's nothing really to risk. How are we doing that?
We're probably all from a different world somewhere.
Yeah.
It's probably not that much difference between us in some ways.
No, we're still kind of acting within our own bubble, like you would be on social media or all these other kind of parts of your life.
Mm.
It's just that. We're all kind of in agreeance all the time,
mm-hmm.
to an extent.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of a polite argument, maybe.
Yeah.
That's the most.
Do you want to repeat your
complaint? I think I was just told to pass on a complaint, I think. I can't remember. I think someone just complained that it was hot as well, and no one was talking. Pretty much the same thing.
I didn't understand. What was the question?
What was the complaint?
The complaint.
From her.
From
anyone.
Earlier on.
It didn't happen.
Yeah, we didn't pass on a complaint. She said he's been complaining for 30 years. Similar. <Simple. laughs>
Standing here and they're expecting. Mm. Nobody gives anything, everybody is expecting. So there is no, well, you come and you make, I have ideas and you talk, but anybody else is standing, what is going on?
There's no guidance. There's no guidance. Why,
yeah.
Why
you're so. Do you think it's part of the camera? Though, and do you think, I find my complaint is that I have a number of complaints. I think this is very distracting, having the cast on video, because it feels like that we have to, are we performing for them, or is there a competition? It also is, my complaint is, I don't know if you interrupted, sometimes it feels like there's something happening in the group, or a conversation might happen, but then there is a bit of direction from you both. And that's interesting because there is this, things can't happen naturally because there's a video and sound playing in another place where it's competing, but there's also some interaction from you guys and then a refusal of an interaction. So it feels both, you want to, something wants to happen naturally, but then it, before people were talking and laughing and you interjected with what is your complaint, and it's like, well, maybe, yeah, I just find it really interesting that there is, as much as this is free or is meant to be maybe free, there's so much still happening by the power of a video camera and your controlled questions and your lack of, like, facial expressions. It's quite interesting. Seriously, like, it's like, I don't know, it's obviously meant to feel uncomfortable, but there's things operating that make it quite hard, I find, anyway. So that's some of my thoughts.
But I wonder if you're implying that there's a canvas that would be kind of like an ideal place for us to interact.
No, I don't think it'd be ideal. I think these are decisions that impact. They're not. There's no ideal place for this kind of thing. I don't know, but I find that there is things operating here that make it maybe not as sort of. I don't feel as comfortable because I find this very distracting, and I find the questions that interact, maybe the natural awkwardness of just standing around in a room and being like, what the fuck are we all doing? Because you still have two people that have a huge amount of power, and you have two people over there that have a huge amount of power. Like, yeah. He scrunched up the piece of paper before. I don't know if anyone else saw that. Like, it's like, because there was someone throwing, like, there's rules.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, and I find that really, I sort of find, that's what makes me, I don't trust it. I don't
there
feel.
Are instructions. All the instructions are here, but none of you trying to play the concert. You came into a concert and you assume the passive position of the viewer. But everything you need to know is in the score, in the instructions. None of you had at least one bit of chance to attempt. The other one left because she was bored, but she didn't do anything. So there's not a show, you have to make it.
Yeah, I know, but I know that, but maybe, of course, the score is laughter. But the score can be, is that laugh? Like, what is your.
It doesn't have to be.
Why does it have to be. Yeah, but also, why can't the audience challenge what that is? I mean, you're invited to a space. Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm talking.
No, like, I think yeah, there could be a musicality to it, but you know, the score is for the concert that has a duration of, what, 167 days. It's not for today.
It's for every day.
It's for every day. It's for the whole thing.
So where's your part in the
100? But can I answer
that
question?
Right now, right?
Yeah,
right.
Yeah.
There are so many therapies in that text, and you didn't try to do one. So
that's
I
think
you
need to
score right now.
No, that's not true.
Yeah. Perhaps he's just provoking us.
But I think it's entirely untrue, because our presence here is the music or the performance or the performative aspect. Our presence and our proximity and our breath and our thoughts, that is the experience and it is the orchestration. So that's entirely untrue.
Interesting, you said that they have power.
Yeah, there you go. Like, this is, it's control, obviously. And even if I get a piece of paper, I don't have to do that.
No, you don't have to. You are asked to.
Yeah, and
since you're coming here.
Yeah, and when I came in here, I was, the way that I was playing with this at the start, I was making beats to myself and I was sick to see if anyone was copying it and doing that. I did that. And now I have to describe it to you as a defense to let you know that I was making sound, that I was interested. Yeah.
It's not about sound.
Yeah, well, yeah, but I was...
You didn't play any of your fellow players here.
I copied what they were physically doing.
You didn't use them as instruments. Okay. You see?
What is here?
But that's not
the same. We made a lot of signals from the beginning, including that piece of paper, but also from the... sort of leaders of this session, we've been getting a lot of signals, not just the first one. So I think we've been updating our way of processing this thing, and it's come to this. So it's surprising, I think, for us to hear that we didn't properly listen to instructions from the instructions.
Sure. You say you listen to instructions, I said we listen carefully, that's the first instruction.
No. How do you know we didn't do that, though? How do you know I didn't do that?
Well, there was an amazing space.
What is amazing space?
Meaning, it's English. Are you listen? Like you hear
what kind of?
But you listen to me.
But it's like, so that you're saying it may.
It's not listening carefully.
I think that's just a personal judgment. I don't think it's got any truth to it. Yeah. Can I make a suggestion? You know how we've been talking about what's the norm?
Can we make this space here for you, so you don't freak out or pass out in the
evening
or whatever? Yeah, that's my job.
But can we talk about something that is something positive is too strong a word, but something interesting for us out of this experience or out of anything, rather than what we want to complain about? Is there anything interesting?
What's the reason? What's
the
reason why you're here?
I was heading to
look for something happens with the documenta, or
why am I here?
Yeah,
because I'm an artist in New Zealand, and this was a big exciting moment for me to get all the way from Australia, as we all know, and do documenta and then which is what we're probably all doing. But the reason I came in here was because I was hungry and tired and I was heading out home.
Yeah.
And all of you were standing there and I was like, what's happening here? I have this out syndrome. Yeah. So I stopped. But I was a little bit scared about and not being able to escape, but I'm fine now. What about everyone else? What about you guys? Is anything interesting or thoughts happening?
I don't feel that good right now, because maybe it's just me, but this interaction was so aggressive and I don't want to be part of that, because when I don't know why I should be aggressive right now, and I don't know why I should be the one performing right now. I guess that's not why I came here. I'm not like showing anything to anyone, I don't know, and especially not a camera, and I don't know who's watching behind that camera, so I don't feel good showing parts of me.
I just didn't hear. Why?
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I was here too much.
Probably, yeah.
I was. Sorry.
You thought you were part of the audience. You got tricked.
I don't know. I always am. I think it's just me. I don't like being in the center and the middle of everything all the time.
Audiences are passive.
Yeah.
It's still part of the performance, whether you're sitting down, whether you're watching, or whether you're acting.
I missed some input from somebody else, from the team, like where we can start discussing or doing something. Like we're sitting here, it's hot. There's nothing, not even painting, where I I can say, oh, do you like it? Like, don't you like it? You know?
Well,
so we don't know what we are talking about.
Why does it need to come from them? I think, at least to my eyes, it's clear that we're just inventing the experience that we're having based on our interactions with each other. So, I mean, we can make a polite conversation and take it from there, or, I don't know, something else like this.
In defense of the monitor, the third paragraph is like a pretty clear prompt for discussion.
What is it? Read it to us?
Hold on. I didn't think it up, which is why I found that a moment ago. Prepare the audience with concepts, questions, and movements as a way to explore the dissonance that exists between the individual narcissism that capitalism promotes and our social capacity. Between how we perceive ourselves as free individuals with agency and the way that we are socially determined by capitalist relations, technology, and ideology. I, like everyone else, probably read this as instructions for our friends.
Yes.
Yeah. In hindsight, I probably read it quite differently, where all individuals, but there's obviously some social interaction going on, but the intrusion of technology pretty blatantly, hello. And I haven't thought about it much more than that, but does anyone have any thoughts about the paragraph, or is that prompting them?
Well, I feel like this is not the proper instruction, because I don't know what to say or talk or do about my social capacity. That's just not like topic I can talk about.
Yeah.
So
yes, it's art, it's intentionally obtuse. I know what you mean though. Reflect on the I/we relation while defining social dissonance. There you go, that's an essay topic for anyone who studies art.
Isn't it clear, cliche, you know?
Yes.
The narcissism that capitalism promotes, I mean, so first capitalism, so how do we conceive of that, you know, relations, or is it something industrial? Or,
yes, it's very generalized.
Who went to art school here?
Who went to art school here?
So you should all be practicing.
It's really a side of my
hands.
We all have certain.
To get here, we have to get here. We have to manage this ourselves in our system to get ourselves on the plane.
Mm. Have you been to any other place at the operator here?
Only to the main museum, like what one is called.
The contemporary art.
I'm trying not to go to too much because my brother's coming tomorrow.
Okay. Okay.
I'm trying to just absorb Athens and everyone.
So you started the questions of complaints at the start.
I feel like that's eight lenses here.
Yeah. Their critique from this gentleman here, because that, I think it was interesting that why they chose complaint and how that set up a certain dynamic and how we keep referring back to that, how that's used and why it was that question and why it wasn't. Yeah, I just, this piece of paper is not very useful to me. I find the first line, after listen carefully, I'm really hung up on that line. The audience is your instrument. Play it in order to practically understand how we generally instrumentalized. I'm just, yeah, and now I'm just sort of thinking about how useful this is as a tool for us. I don't know what everyone else thinks about it. But I think, yeah, it was interesting how dialogue started in here and how voice sort of happened is through this question of what do we have to complain about?
Isn't it quite shocking that we are expecting a leader and we are so uncomfortable when there is no leader? And, yeah, so I don't know what to do. I'm short before be the leader and doing some funny stuff and you're all doing it and we're all happy. Yeah,
I found this conversation about expectations very much to the point and very interesting in order to understand better what is going on here. It is very obvious that when we don't have certain instructions or a way to continue being inside the space, it is very hard to find our own way to navigate our experience. And I found it very interesting that this person over here, who has seen again the performance, could speak about it. And I think it was the first person that took so much time speaking. So I found it very interesting, especially because of the fact that we were speaking about another concert that happened in Kassel in order to define our experience here. And at this moment, we did not pay so much attention to what was actually happening inside the space. Or the comment about the fact that there is nothing in this room to... there is no input, there is no painting, there is not... a visible work of art that we can talk about. There's only us and a blank room, and then it is very hard to make something out of it.
But I think it's interesting what you said when you first started that statement about not having any kind of instructions or anything, because for me there's so much already happening in this room that I don't feel comfortable doing things. That's my issue, is what my complaint was. This makes me feel very uncomfortable. The way this is sort of set up makes me feel uncomfortable. I do a lot of performance art. I've been in a lot of participatory things. That isn't to sort of say, I think this is bad or wrong. It might be saying my judgment, my experience, the interaction with the invigilators. It does, there already is sort of rules happening, and it does make me, I like to move, I like to do things, I like to mimic people. I'm a performance artist, so I think for me it actually there already is things here that have made me not sort of do whatever I'm meant to do. I don't know if other people feel like that. Maybe if there was not a camera, I feel like maybe people, or if there wasn't this here, and I understand it's part of the show, but
it seems like you hit a point, interesting point about comfort.
Yes, yeah.
And you mentioned it as well about feeling uncomfortable and going, well, it's okay. We come in here to hopefully absorb a performance, or is this somehow another type of performance that questions comfort and the way we experience things?
The night social dissonance. So
maybe we're not having enough of them. Sorry.
Yes. Or I would say so. I think. Like in terms of
and when an hour, how much conflict will you experience? And really it's frustrating. I think this is a frustrating performance because on the one hand I'm very excited by this opportunity to talk to total random strangers that I see on the street. And I would like to talk to them sometimes, and when there's somehow a distance that prevents me from doing so here, this very interesting opportunity to talk to random people, it's very nice, I think. But it only lasts for an hour, and we're all, you know, going to go back to our regular social contracts, etc. I wish this was happening in some sort of underground situation with no rules, and it would be very risky and dangerous and actually illegal. Like, no, it's true, it's true. I mean, I think real experimental theater of this kind cannot be legal because there are things that prevent this.
But don't you think like this kind of needs to happen within an institution? I think there is that kind of element to like this kind of this depressing kind of structure. Well, there's a dynamic that's set up here that if it was this underground world, you know, it would just be going on. Like, you know, it'd be a very different dynamic. And I don't know what I mean.
So we need a leader, I think. And now we are thinking we must perform.
Stop it. Oh.
Τίποτα, το κατέβασα έτσι και έβγαλε άλλο πράγμα από ό,τι έβγαζε συνήθως. Να σου πω για ποιο είναι.
Το χάσαμε.
Τι! Πώς γίνεται αυτό!
Θέλω να σου το πω, γιατί κάποιες φορές θέλει πάρα πολύ προσοχή με αυτό το πράγμα. Αλλά αλήθεια δεν μπορώ να ασχοληθώ άλλο. Απλά δεν θα το ανεβάσουμε. Δεν μπορώ να ασχοληθώ άλλο με αυτά. Να σου πω, α, πες ακόμα ρε.